Hi, this is Lisa McClowry, and I'm at the beautiful Butcher Boy recording studio here in Evanston. This is owned by Jim Tullio, and I'm telling you, I'm so impressed by this Neve board. He tells me it's an 8078 Neve board. It's one of 18 boards left here in, just left out in there in the music world. So it's gorgeous. I don't know if you can get a good close-up of all this, but it's pretty impressive, and so is the studio. But guess what? I've got some really awesome people here today hanging out. We have Mr. Danny Seraphine from the group CTA, formerly of Chicago.
Yes.
My buddy Danny.
Hello,
sweetie. Hi.
Hi, it's good to see you.
How are you today?
I'm great.
You know, we've talked before, and I just thought today we'd talk about something not so businessy.
Okay.
Just something, you know, we talked a little bit in the car on the way here about being a drummer and your age and things that are happening. You know, I think it'd be really interesting for drummers out there to know what they might expect, or because so many people look up to you.
Well,
it's not a negative.
No. It's a reality. I'm a 65-year-old athlete, which is against the rules, sort
Absolutely.
Of. No one. I don't think anybody expected us to be playing rock and roll at 65 or 70 or 75. And drummers, being the most physical, well, Jim Tullio is also having. You know, we have issues.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to have surgery on my foot at some point. It's okay. I mean, I've been playing drums for over 50 years. 52 years to be exact, or 56 years. I'm 65. I started when I was 9. So the math, whatever the math works out. So sooner or later, body parts wear out. But I'm going to blaze a hole here. I'm not done playing yet. So
it's
just, I've got arthritis and this and that. But I still love to play, and I feel like I'm playing better than I ever played in many respects. I've kind of replaced my fastball with a wicked slider, so to speak. So.
I'm excited. Then.
Yeah, this studio. I feel like I'm in heaven here.
Jim's
created an amazing place here.
So we've got Jim Tullio. He's the owner. He's a producer. He's done all kinds of things. You need to look him up.
Bassist extraordinaire, right?
We've coaxed him to play with us today. He's got a sore finger. We said, please play with us. We want to do a Chicago song since we have Danny here, and we're just going to be hanging out. And over there, we got our buddy John Blasucci.
Mm-hmm.
He's a film composer. You write music for film, but you're also a pianist in Dennis Dan's group.
That is correct.
Since we have all this talent in the room, and we've got Greg Bizzaro from Jaffe Films filming us, hi, and John Bizzaro, I thought, you know what, let's just do something impromptu, off the cuff. We really didn't rehearse this, and that's
the
way.
This is my new band, Lisa, the Dago Brothers.
The Dago Brothers. Don't
yeah, Greaseball.
The Greaseball.
So I love this song. So I think.
Should we give it a go?
Let's give it a go. And again, we're just we're hanging out here. This has not been rehearsed, and we're just doing it raw.
Just
the way I like it.
See what happens here.
Say from me.
day. Far away from the one that I love. Oh, now it's hard for me to say I'm sorry. I just want you to know.
Something. So he's this 65-year-old guy who says he's falling apart.
Yeah,
blow us away.
Still play.
Oh my God.
I love
you're
the
a
play.
Monster.
Yeah.
It's awesome. And this has
you're
just been
kind.
So much
thank
fun.
You.
Thank you again.
You're welcome. Mm-hmm. You're welcome. Thanks.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thanks, guys.